To cope with the intrinsic problem of eliciting requirements, many different techniques have been proposed. So here I list some of the most traditional techniques for requirements elicitation. And as I present those, please keep in mind that these techniques can be used separately or combined. A first technique is called background reading. And this technique involves collecting information by reading existing documents such as company reports, organizational charts, policy manuals, job descriptions, documentation of existing systems, and so on. And this technique is especially appropriate when one is not familiar with the organization for which the requirements are being collected. So you want to get some background before interviewing actual people. And one of the main limitations of these kind of approaches is that written documents might be out of sync, and they often are out of sync with reality, tend to be long-winded, and may contain many relevant details. So you may have to look at a lot of materials to extract enough information. The hard data and samples techniques consist in deciding which hard data we want to collect and choosing the sample of the population for which to collect such data. And hard data includes facts and figures, such as forms, invoices, financial information, survey results, marketing data, and so on. And the sampling of this data can be done in different ways, for example, typical ways to do random selection. Interviews are another typical approach for requirements elicitation. And this is the approach that we use for the first project in this course, for instance. Interviews can be structured, in which case there is an agenda of fairly open questions, or they can be open-ended, in which case there is no preset agenda and the interview is more of a conversation. On the positive side, interviews can collect a rich set of information because they allow for uncovering opinions as well as hard facts. Moreover, they can probe in depth through follow-up questions. On the more negative side, interviewing requires special skills that are difficult to master and require experience. And it is not enough to collect a lot of information. If this information is hard to analyze or even irrelevant, it might become useless. So you need to know how to conduct an interview in order to take advantage of these techniques. Surveys can also be extremely useful for gathering requirements because they can quickly collect information from a large number of people. Moreover, they can be administered remotely, for example, by email, through the web. On the other hand, surveys tend to severely constrain the information that the user can provide and might miss opportunities to collect unforeseen relevant information. Finally, meetings are generally used for summarization of findings and collection of feedback so as to confirm or refute what has been learned. So the only additional thing I want to mention about meetings is the fact that it is fundamental that they have clearly stated objectives and are planned carefully. This is something that should be quite obvious, but doesn't always happen in practice.